beer. Lift your stein and drink your beer. Drink, drink, drink to eyes that are bright as stars when they're shining on me.
Drink, drink, drink to lips that are red and sweet as the fruit on the tree. Here's a hope that those bright eyes will shine lovingly, longingly soon into mine. May those lips that are red and sweet tonight with joy my own lips meet. Drink, drink, let the toast start. May young hearts never part. Drink, 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 let every true lover salute his sweetheart.
Howdy, patrol members, and welcome to another episode of Mojave Patrol. We're going to do a whiskey and a cigar review. Well, actually, no, I'm lying to you. Telling you a falsehood. We will do a cigar review from one out of the bundle, and that's Oro Cubano. And I don't know anything about it. It says imported, handmade, and anniversary. All right. I got my grape Kool-Aid. But this is a little cocktail bomb. Now, supposedly, you put your whiskey and you can use water, you can use straight whiskey if you know you want to use that much. Or you can use whatever your favorite mixer is, and you drop it in a glass there with your whiskey and makes your cocktail. Now the lady said, we bought them from, said that the wrapper was made out of some kind of beet sugar, but the instructions that come with it say remove the wrapper. So I've removed the wrapper. So we conveniently have our Redneck Riviera here, the one we used the other day for the toast. And I'm going to pour myself a jigger. Jigger and a half. That looks good. Redneck Riviera. Let me turn that down a bit. I think that's too bright. How's that? I'm going to turn it up later. It's starting to get dark out. I'm going to take my club soda, which is just a store brand club soda. I'm going to pour it in the whiskey. I'm going to take my little knife, stir it up. And then we're going to taste it. Tastes like whiskey and soda, and we're going to drop.
It was at this moment he knew. He fucked up.
Ooh. Uh-oh. And you can see it, theoretically turning into a whiskey sour. We'll just let that percolate. Now I have a big mess on my patio. So, if you see these things at a liquor store or something like that, keep it in mind that it could overflow. I'm going to take my little souvenir knife. I showed this on the What's in the Box. And we're going to trim the butt end of our cigar. And that cut beautifully, that cheap little knife, because I sharpened it. Now let's try our Oro Cubano. Golden Anniversario. It's anniversary thing. Oro is Spanish for gold. Very mild. It was a very mild aroma. That's still cooking. Let me get my new box of matches here. I know. I got these at a yard sale. I thought they were funny. Okay, that's about run its course. Let's try it. Cheers. Wow. First impression. You can't even tell you put anything in your drink. It looks just like a colored drink. First impression. That is very mild and light. Very mild and light. Pardon me. That's a very good cigar. Like I said, it's not great, but it is good. So far, 2 out of 2 in this bundle. Raji's Untimely Demise and the Oro Cubano, they're both good. So yesterday, Mrs. Patrol and I went to the L.A. County Fair, and compared to 5 years ago, compared to pre-COVID, the fair is exceptionally truncated. You don't have half the people there you used to have. Last night, War was at the grandstand, bandstand, putting on a concert. We had fair food. You'll see in the video, which will probably be Wednesday, this coming Wednesday. So when you see this video, it'll be the following Saturday. We went on opening day, which happened to be Mrs. Patrol's birthday. And, it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad. And I'll tell you, but I tell you one thing I did anticipate. Not all the vendors were present. There were all kinds of places reserved for vendors that weren't there yet because it was opening day. We thought they opened at 10 a.m. In reality, they opened at 5 p.m. So not everybody was set up. I I'm going to recommend that if you're security conscious, keep an eye open, because when we walked through the security at the entrance, it was notably lacking. None of our, even though they were supposed to inspect your bags, none of the bags were inspected. I left my pocket knives at home because you can't bring them in. They didn't even check. I rode my scooter through the metal detector, and all kinds of bells and whistles went off, and then he just waved me through. Yeah. But it was opening day. And there were no incidents that I recall happening while we were there from opening till closing. So opening day price was $10, but since we're seniors, that was our normal price. But we did pay for VIP parking, and just so you know, if you're going to go up there and say, I like VIP parking, it's going to be $35. The same parking price you pay to go to Disneyland parking, $35. So there. They parked you, they showed you where to park. We didn't have a problem there, but on leaving, their parking department was decidedly lacking. There were very few people directing traffic. So, there you go. As far as everything else at the fair, the food was fair prices. I mean, for a souvenir cup of beverage, it's $8.50, but if you want that refilled throughout the park, throughout the fair, the rest of the day, you're only going to pay $5 for a refill, and it's a large drink. Hot dog on a stick was $8. Marlene got a barbecue sandwich, which was, she couldn't finish it. It was big. But that was like, I think, $12.95 or something like that. The Garden Railroad wasn't running. There was some entertainment, you know, like I said, but as a whole, we enjoyed it. Now, we're going to go back. We bought a new mattress, well, a new bed, because our bed is kind of beat up. So we were there. We felt the price was reasonable for what we were getting, so we bought. We bought some lamps. We bought some tchotchkes, you know. Marlene bought some more Cutco knives. But as a whole, I'd say we had a good time, a pretty good time. So we are planning on returning. I have a Disneyland video coming out. It's a little janky. I apologize. I really wasn't planning on making a video there, but at the last minute, I grabbed a camera. I have a... Oh, and I bought a new body cam. You wear on your body. So when you watch the County Fair video, I'm going to apologize in advance. It had a little plastic cover over the lens, a little tiny one. I didn't see it, so I didn't remove it. So I have this weird, hazy, fisheye view of everything, and I really apologize for that. But there's not a lot of that footage. Aside from that, we had a good time at Disneyland. We took my granddaughter to Disneyland with us. One of the problems with Disneyland is the reservation system. Now, since I have cast member privileges, I'm retired from there, Marlene and I don't have to pay for parking or to get in. Where they get us is, we can only make same-day reservations. So if we plan on going to Disneyland, and we look for reservations and none are available, then we have to make other plans. So three out of four times now, I'm pretty sure it's that, we've been able to get in on the same day, so I'm not complaining. I feel very thankful that I have the privileges I do for getting into Disneyland and California Adventure. A lot of times, well, I'm not going to get into that philosophical stuff. But a lot of things in life are privileges. Be thankful for what you have. Because there's a lot of places on Earth where people don't have one hundredth of what we have. And I don't care who you are living in this country. If you live here legally, illegally, whatever, but you're living here, you're lucky. You're lucky. Well, it's getting darker now. It's 62 degrees outside, and it's 20 minutes to 8. I'll put the appropriate metric stuff in here somewhere. It is 80% humidity out, and it's totally overcast, and my weather liar on my phone says we have a 50% chance of rain tonight after 11 p.m. Now, I looked on the weather map, and to the northeast of us, it is raining. So somebody's getting rained on, you know. But anyway, let's try this again. Now it's completely done bubbling. It tastes ever so slightly like a whiskey sour. So if you buy one of these bombs at the fair, one, it's the same price as an entire bottle of whiskey sour mix at Walmart. So I bought one just to try it. Not doing it again. So there you have it. The Oro Cubano, good smoke. Good smoke. And the Redneck Riviera whiskey, it's good. Is it great? No. Is it good? Yes. I give the whiskey 4 Joshua Trees. I give the cigar 4 Joshua Trees. And I give this bomb a creosote bush. That is below 1 Joshua Tree. Just a little creosote bush. Yeah. Not great. Anyway, I'd like to thank everybody for joining me. Thanks for being here with me for this little review. Like and subscribe, leave a comment, you know, whatever. Once again, I'm not monetized. Everything I do comes out of my own pocket. So I've got no Patreon. I'm not asking you for anything but to click the like. I'm not asking you for money, not asking you for anything. I just really appreciate those people that watch my videos. Close to 500 now. As far as I'm concerned, it's close to 500. Hopefully I can get 500 subscribers. So you know what, folks? If you want to watch just a video a lot of times about my life, just have your friends tune in, you know? And they can say, oh, thank God. My life is better than his. I should be thankful. Oh. I wish I could get out to the desert more right now, but I got solar roofing going to be put on. I got sprinklers going to be put in. I got people to clean up the backyard. I got a lot of stuff going on. I don't know when I'm going to find the time to do that, and I apologize for that. I know it's called the Mojave Patrol, and this past year or so, we haven't done a lot of Mojave patrolling. But hopefully that's going to change coming up here in, by this coming fall. Even if I have to cruise around by myself, I'm going to do it. Which is okay. Because you know what? I like me. So, anyway, thanks for watching. I appreciate it once again. And we'll see you later, Mater.
In television and electronics, the name Dumont is your hallmark of quality and distinction. Dumont, first with the finest in television.